आईयूपीएससी, इट स्टैंड फॉर व्हाट? इंटरनेशनल यूनियन ऑफ प्योर एंड अप्लाइड केमिस्ट्री। When we have so many compound known today, it is very difficult to write for all the compound common names and memorize or remember all the common names. So we follow a system in which we have some rules. As per those rules, we write the compounds IUPAC names. That is called IUPAC nomenclature. For writing the compound IUPAC nomenclature, we in a name we can have some parts. Like if I take an example first, then I will explain the different terms involved there. If I take an example of compound CH3, CH, double bond CH, CHOH, COOH, a compound taken this one here. For this compound, the question is given to write the IUPAC name. I not told you write the rules, I am just telling you in a name what can be the components. In this compound names, this compound have name what here? देखिए इसमें क्या होता है? We will tell the, all these rules, how to rule. Numbering done here. First, we take numbering of carbon chain 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You have 5 carbon atoms. OH in this case is acting as prefix, as a functional group, but not the main functional group taken as prefix name, as a substituent. This compound has name 2-hydroxy. 2-hydroxy. You take root word is taken. Pent. 5 carbon atoms, then at alkene third position we have double bond, so 3-ene, and then 1 oic acid or directly can write here simply enoic acid. So in this is the compound one IUPAC name. Name can have some parts, like it can have which part? It is taken one part taken is prefix. In a compound name, we can have prefix or prefixes. We can have one or more than one prefix possible. Then, if we have more than one prefix, then we arrange prefixes. Arranged in alphabetical order. If we have more than one prefix, otherwise single, then no problem. If we have more than one prefix or prefixes, then we arrange them in alphabetical order. Then we take one term is called root word. We take pent is taken root word. This root word will give, it gives the indicator, gives the number of carbon atoms in principal carbon chain. It is taken pent root word. We have 5 carbon atoms in the main carbon chain, so we take it is pent is taken root word. Then third term taken is ene. At third position, so ene is taken what here? Ene in this case is taken as primary suffix. It is taken primary suffix. They indicate if compound is saturated or unsaturated. It indicates whether compound is saturated or compound is unsaturated. Then you take this word oic acid. It is taken as secondary suffix. It is taken secondary suffix. It indicates main or principal functional group. It indicate main or principal functional group. So in a compound we can have these parts. Some parts may be there or may not be involved, but like first part may be there, may not be there, but definitely for a compound we will have root word. Again we can have primary suffix or we can have secondary suffix also, and we write them in same sequence. In writing the compound IUPAC nomenclature, we will write first prefix. If we have more than one prefix, then we arrange them in alphabetical order. Then we take root word. And then if the compound is saturated, means without double bonds or triple bonds, then the compound is saturated. or if compound is unsaturated, means if they have double bond or triple bonds in the structure, then the compound said to be unsaturated, and then we indicate an end here is secondary suffix. So in the compound they are the components of a compound's IUPAC nomenclature. Now root word we will take here before given number of carbon atoms, what can be root word. Let us take a list of compound list of compounds with the root word taken different here. Now we can take nomenclature of first saturated hydrocarbons, which are commonly called alkanes. For alkanes they will have general formula CnH2n+2. So we can take the name of compounds given here in the list. When the one carbon name is methane, two carbon name is ethane, three carbon is propane, four carbon is butane, five carbon pentane, six pe hexane, seven heptane, eight pe octane, nine pe nonane, ten pe decane. It is almost known to you all of you. फिर भी एक बार लिस्ट दिखा पूरा यहां पर है. फॉर्मूला कैन फिट अकॉर्डिंगली CnH2n+2. व्हाट इज रूट वर्ड इन ईच केस. इन द रूट फॉर राइटिंग रूट वर्ड रिमूव द सफिक्स ane. लाइक इन फर्स्ट केस वी हैव रूट वर्ड मीथेन का मिथ, इथेन का इथ. रिमूव द लास्ट ane वर्ड मीथेन का मिथ, इथ, प्रोप, ब्यूट, पेंट, हेक्स, हेप्ट, ऑक्ट, non deck. Means this name is a prop butane. तो कब इसमें देखा but pent hex hept oct non deck. Means in all the cases we just remove the last suffix ane from the name, then they give the root word of the compound. Root word is given here in the list here. And when we have more than 10 carbons, you try to keep in mind at least till 12 carbon, because sometime in 1-2 question may be given up to 12 carbon, but 10 carbon is sufficient for knowing the name of the root word or the principal carbon chain or hydrocarbon chain name. Now in this case when we have 11 carbon name is undecane. Now I'm not writing the root word here, just remove ane, part remaining is root word. In C12 formula C12H26 dodecane, C13H28 tridecane, so tridecane is in this case root word, C14H30 tetradecane, tetradec, C19H40 nonadec, C20H42 icosane का icos, C21 henicosane, 22 docosane, 30 triacontane. So we have in this case root word triacont. Means in the compound complete name remove the last word ane suffix, remaining part is the root word. Root word have been underlined in the given compounds. Now if we have more than 30 carbon, it is for just information. Nobody is going to ask question of formula or write in the naming of compound which are more than 11-12 carbon maximum. Anyway, I'll write the name for compound having more than even 30 carbons. Like when we have C40, 40 carbon compounds, formula can be C40H, 80+2, 82, name can be taken tetracontane. Tetracontane, if you have 40 carbon, 50 carbon pentacontane, C50H102 pentacontane, C60 hexacontane, C60, 70, 80, 90 accordingly, 90 if it is taken, C90, H182, the name become here, nonacontane, C100, H202, name is taken heptane. So that is the compounds saturated hydrocarbons names. Basically these names are given to you for the root word. For the root word this has been taken here. Now in the root word taken here, sometimes this alkyl group can be taken as a prefix name, meaning as a substituent, then how to write the name here? So it is alkanes. From alkane we write the alkyl groups. So let us take some common alkyl groups names. You can take alkane. From alkane we write alkyl group. How we write alkyl group? Remove one hydrogen atom, loss of hydrogen from alkane give alkyl group. Names can be taken accordingly. Like we just taken alkane is CH4. Then for alkane the group is taken what here when they use hydrogen? CH3 group. Name is here methyl. Sometimes write only symbol ME for methyl. Symbol taken ME for methyl. If you have seed H3CH3 ethane, then for ethane the group can be taken CH3CH2 ethyl. Symbol taken ET. ET for ethyl group. Propyl C3H8. It can have two structures possible. I'll explain to you that also. Group is taken C3H7. Name is propyl. PR C4H10 is butane. Alkane group is what here? C4H9 butyl. Symbol taken BU butyl. So and so on. Can take C5 pentane is removed from the alkane. If it is taken, how we get the name here? Replace the term ANE alkane by YL. For writing the name of the alkyl group from alkane, remove ANE, replace ANE by YL. So alkane we will write as alkyl group. Alkane we write as alkyl group. That is how you write methane say methyl, ethane say ethyl, propane say propyl, butane say butyl, and so on. How you write the compounds names in the groups, it is written this way here. If I take an alkenes, suppose we take 2-3 examples of alkenes, like if it is taken ethene, CH2 double bond CH2, then remove hydrogen, the remaining group is CH2 double bond CH, it is taken as ethinyl, or common name is taken vinyl. Ethinyl or vinyl. If I take CH2, CH3, CH double bond CH2, remove hydrogen, it is propene. CH3, CH double bond CH is called as propenyl group. Propenyl group. If you remove from here hydrogen, CH2, CH, CH2. Name is allyl group. Means we remove this hydrogen. From here the name is allyl group. There are some very common groups, especially this methyl, ethyl, propyl, butyl. For dhyan rakhenge aap log. Now in methyl or ethyl we have one thing. See one thing more. Methyl or ethyl we have both carbon. In this case identical, only one carbon. But in propyl group propane, we have carbons of two category. Carbon can be taken primary or carbon can be taken secondary. So what is meaning of this term primary, secondary, tertiary carbon? Replacing hydrogen from them, the name become different. So we can use for them some separate names and common names that we will discuss now. Now we can take first type of carbon atoms which can be called primary carbon, secondary carbon, tertiary carbon and 4-degree carbon. So the meaning of that? First we take primary carbon. Primary carbon means 1-degree carbon. Means a carbon is said to be primary carbon if it is attached to, means a carbon is attached to one more carbon atoms. Attached to one more carbon atom, then the carbon said to be primary. When it is secondary carbon, what is secondary carbon? 2-degree carbon. A carbon is said to be secondary if the carbon atom is attached to more carbon atoms. If a carbon atom is attached to two more carbon atom, then the carbon said to be secondary or 2-degree carbon. Then carbon said to be tertiary, that is 3-degree carbon. Carbon is attached to 3 more carbon atoms, then carbon said to be tertiary or 3-degree carbon, and quaternary carbon, 4-degree carbon means carbon is said to be quaternary if it is attached to 4 more carbon atoms. Attached to 4 more carbon atoms. Like if I take one structure example here, CH3, CH2, CH3. If a compound given, if this and with this formula is given to you, of the compound structure is given. In this case, can you label the carbon, which carbon is primary carbon, secondary carbon, tertiary carbon, or 4-degree carbon atoms? It's very simple. You see the carbon atom. When you take this carbon atom, it's attached to how many more carbon? One more carbon. So this carbon is primary. This carbon attached to one more carbon, so primary. This carbon same primary carbon attached to one more carbon. This carbon is attached to 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon more, so it is called 4-degree carbon atom. This carbon is attached to 1, 2, 2 more carbon atoms, so it is secondary carbon. This carbon atom is attached to 1, 2, 3 more carbon atoms, so it is tertiary carbon atom. It is again primary carbon atom. It is secondary carbon atom. It is again primary carbon atom. Carbon atoms can be named as primary, secondary, tertiary, or 4-degree depending on they are attached to how many more carbon atoms. And then hydrogens are named accordingly. We can have primary hydrogen. This hydrogen can be again said to be same primary hydrogen, secondary hydrogen, tertiary hydrogen, means hydrogens is called primary hydrogens. If hydrogen is attached to primary carbon, is called primary hydrogen. Primary hydrogen. Hydrogen attached to secondary carbon, so hydrogens can also be taken secondary hydrogen or tertiary hydrogen. We don't have quaternary hydrogen. Is depending on same point. If hydrogen attached to primary carbon is called primary hydrogen, hydrogen attached to secondary carbon is called as secondary hydrogen, and hydrogen attached to tertiary carbon is called tertiary hydrogen. Like in this compound taken, we can have how many primary hydrogens? You can count primary carbon, we can have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All carbon primary have 3 hydrogens, so 3 into 5, 15 hydrogens. 15 hydrogen primary hydrogens. How many hydrogen secondary? See the secondary carbon, 1, 2, 2 secondary carbon, so 2 into 2, 4 hydrogen secondary. How many carbon tertiary? Only one. So we have how many tertiary hydrogens? Only one. In the compound of tertiary hydrogen, only one. So hydrogens can be named as primary, secondary, tertiary hydrogen depending they are attached to which kind of carbon atoms. First you identify carbon nature, hydrogen come automatically. Hydrogen ka naam wahi hoga jo carbon ka naam hota hai, jis pe laga hua hai. Agar aapka H laga hua hai primary carbon se, to usko bolte hain primary hydrogen. Agar aapka H laga hai secondary carbon se, usko naam hoga secondary hydrogen. If H laga hai humpe aapka tertiary carbon se, naam is tertiary hydrogen. 4 degree hydrogen possible nahi hai because then carbon cannot be 4 degree. C is only tetravalent maximum. So we cannot have any hydrogen which can be called quaternary hydrogen atoms. We can have hydrogen in these three categories, primary, secondary, tertiary only. So before we move further, we can take this one example to identify number of primary, secondary, tertiary carbons and number of hydrogen accordingly. One compound structure is given to you, in that you identify. Suppose a compound is given to you of the structure. In the given compound, you identify. आपको क्या करना है इसमें? Number of atoms. कौन से आपको बताना atoms हैं? We can take number of hydrocarbon atoms, which is primary, secondary, tertiary, and 4 degree, and hydrogen atoms, which can be primary, secondary, and tertiary hydrogens. What is number of atoms of carbon atoms and hydrogen atoms? Hydrogen atom can be taken of 3 category: primary, secondary, tertiary. Carbon can be taken 4 category in the given compound. You do this question at or on. Now coming on solution part, बहुत easy है इसमें. You can directly put numbers primary, ये होगा इसमें 4 degree, secondary, 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 4 degree again have 4 bonds, tertiary, secondary, primary, secondary, primary, tertiary, tertiary, secondary, secondary, primary, primary. Are the hydrogen atom given to us. अब इसमें आपको numbering करना है. Numbering आपका हो गया सारा. अब आप count कर लीजिए कितने primary आपके H दिख रहे हैं. Primary carbon कितने हैं? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have 6 primary carbon atoms. How many carbon secondary? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You have 8 carbons as secondary carbon. How many tertiary carbon atoms? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 carbon tertiary. How many carbon quaternary? 1, 2, that's all. 2. Then number of H कितना होगा? Primary carbon कितने आपके हैं? 6. So that means 6 into 3. 18 primary hydrogens. Primary carbon is carbon attached to only hydrogen atom, 3 more. Attached to 1 more carbon, then that we have 3 more hydrogens then. Then secondary कितना आपका होगा? 8 into 2, that is 16 hydrogen secondary. And tertiary jitne H jitne carbon utna H, 4 into 1, because tertiary carbon can have only one hydrogen, 4. So that is this answer for this question. So if at all they ask identification of primary, secondary, tertiary and 4 degree carbon, you can identify easily. I hope it is clear. Now next coming here, next point taken here is means identification of using prefixes N, iso, secondary and neo. Now next can be taken uses of prefixes N, iso, neo or secondary. In common names we are using sometimes, in some IPS names they can be used sometimes, but common names they are using. Iska meaning kya hota hai? N, iso, neo. Dekhi, we have taken for writing the naming of the alkyl group. We are using them for writing the naming of alkyl groups. We are using them. So if it is taken methane or ethane, there is no question. But when the group is propane, we have 2 kind of carbon atoms, primary carbon or secondary carbon. So if we remove hydrogen from this positions or this position, they give different group. When we remove this hydrogen, they can give one group here, this one, or they can give second group CH3. CH, CH3. So both are having 3 carbons. So name is propyl in both the case. First one is named as what? N-propyl. N-propyl. N stand for normal. Normal means no branching in the carbon chain. Without branching in the carbon chain, we use prefix N. N-propyl, straight chain without any branching. Now if you remove secondary carbon here, then for them use prefix iso, or short is I. It is I or isopropyl. Isopropyl. Iso means they contain this isopropyl group. The compounds which are having such kind of grouping, in their name you can use prefix iso. So iso is the common prefix here, or N. Propyl indicating 3 carbon atoms in the alkyl group. When we take propane, we have 3 possibilities. Now if it is taken butane, four carbon compounds. In that, what possibilities can be there? Let us see. If you take butane, butane can be written two ways: CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3. Or we can write butane this way also. It is called as N-butane without branching. It is called N-butane. Compound common name. It has one isopropyl group. So we can use prefix iso. Four carbon. So name is butane. Isobutane. N-butane, isobutane. N-butane, we have two possibilities. We can remove hydrogen from this position or from these two positions. If we remove first or last hydrogen, they are identical. The formula can be written as CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3, 2. Or if we remove from here hydrogen, the group is taken this one. We can have two groups. First one is called as N-butyl. N is without branching in the carbon chain. N-butyl. And it is, we can use for this name, secondary butyl. SEC for secondary, secondary butyl. We are removing hydrogen atom from secondary carbon. अब देखो ना, ये primary carbon है, secondary carbon से दोनों, ये primary carbon फिर से है. If we remove secondary hydrogen atom here, because we are using the term here secondary, four carbons of butyl. In this case, we can add again two possibilities. Either we can remove from here hydrogen, or from here we can remove hydrogen. There are three carbon equivalent, three primary carbons hain. So if we remove from here hydrogen, CH3, CH, CH2, it is group. Or I can add CH3 group. So we can have two group here. In this case, it contain isopropyl group. The compound having isopropyl group, for them naming, we are using prefix iso. Four carbon in total, so name is isobutyl. In this case, one carbon is tertiary. From where we remove hydrogen, so name is tert-butyl. Tert stands for tertiary. Tertiary. Meaning from tertiary, carbon atom, we are removing hydrogen. So we are writing them, carbon have free valency as tertiary position, so tertiary butyl. In this case, compound have isopropyl group, for them we use prefix iso. We will have name of the alkyl group indicating all the number of carbon atoms. Four carbon name is butyl. So we can have, when you take five carbon compounds, we can have again possibilities N-pentyl, secondary pentyl, isopentyl. Let us write that also. If it is taken pentane derivative, C5H12. In this case, we can have different what groups, alkyl groups here. So one can be taken straight chain without any branch. It is N pentyl. N for normal, without branch, 5 carbon. So pentyl is the name here. Or you can take CH3. CH3, it is taken secondary pentyl group. If I write here CH2 group, it contain isopropyl group, so name is here isopentyl group. If it is taken, one carbon is 4 degree carbon free, carbon tertiary free, then the name is taken here, tert or tertiary pentyl. In this case, one more structure is possible. If I remove from such a structure one hydrogen from this position, from here we have one more hydrogen which is removed. For then we can use the prefix neo. When we have one carbon quaternary in the structure, what then we can use prefix neo. It has how many carbon? 5 carbon. So name is neo pentyl. The compound name is neopentyl. Pentyl for 5 carbons, neo for such kind of grouping. So I hope it is clear that using prefixes N, iso, neo, secondary in the compound structures or the names. Okay. Now next, we can take some practice of the names of compounds. First common names and then we take IUPAC names. Now next can be taken nomenclature of branched chain alkanes. For them, how to write the compounds names. Now in nomenclature or naming the branch chain alkanes, we follow some rules. What are rules taken here? First can be taken selection of principal or main carbon chain. Selection of principal or main carbon chain. If a compound have different substituents in the main chain, then you can take one of the chain is taken as main carbon chain. As a rule, what is taken here? Okay, which carbon chain can be main carbon chain? The longest carbon chain to be taken as main carbon chain. If suppose we have two or more carbon chains of same length, then more branching or more number of branches in the carbon chain to be taken if we have two or more identical chains. So that is first selection of the principal carbon chain or main carbon chain. That carbon chain is taken as the main carbon chain, which is longest. First of all, if we have two or more carbon chains of same length, then that carbon chain to be taken as principal carbon chain, which contain more number of branches. Like if I take for this point to explain here, I'm writing only carbon atoms here. In this case, which carbon chain can be taken as main carbon chain? We can take numbering of the chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This carbon chain to be taken as a principal carbon chain for naming this compound. For naming this compound, because this carbon chain is longest. Other carbon chains are having 7 atoms. This carbon chain is having 8 atoms. Now suppose we have two or more chains of same length. Now in this case, which carbon chain can be taken main carbon chain? See, we are having carbon chain lengths. If it is taken, one chain is this one here, longest carbon chain. This carbon chain is longest, or this carbon chain, all are equal chains. We have three chains as the same chain length. Kaise hua? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Three chains of same carbon chain length. In such a case, which chain to be selected as the principal carbon chain? That carbon chain which contain more number of branches. If you take straight carbon chain, it have two branches. One this group here. If I take this carbon chain, we'll also have, then we can have how many branches here? 1, 2, 3 branches. So we can take in this case, this is identical. This or this is same. So if I take here this one here, this carbon chain to be selected as the principal carbon chain in this case, because this carbon chain is containing more number of branches. Ab count kar lijiye, 1, 2, 3 branches. If I take carbon chain, this one will have two branch only. So if we have two or more identical carbon chains, then that carbon chain to be taken principal carbon chain which contain more number of substituents or branches. I hope it is clear this point. Selection is the first of the principal carbon chain or main carbon chain. Now second, numbering of the carbon chain. Second point taken, numbering of the carbon chain, numbering of carbon atoms of principal carbon chain or main carbon chain. So in numbering, what are the criteria for numbering of the carbon atoms in the chain? We should follow lowest number to first locant. First locant. That first locant of substituents should get lowest number. Locant in this case also means group, or substituent should get lowest number. So lowest number to first locant rule, it is as per lowest number to first locant rule. Now in case if we are having locant on same positions, first locant on same positions in two or more chains, then we can follow what here? Lowest sum rule. Lowest sum rule. If now this one normally is used when we have more than two groups or locants. If we have more than two locants, then we follow lowest sum rule. But lowest number to first locant, this rule is given priority or dominate. The priority given to lowest number to first locant rule. If this is not there, if it is obeyed in either side, then we see this point also. Like how to take numbering, if I take example wise, in this case how to take numbering of the carbon chain. Numbering can be done from either side. First select longest carbon chain, longest आपका straight ले सकते हैं और ये भी ले सकते हैं, एक ही बात है वो. तो इसमें क्या होगा, नंबरिंग कैसे करेंगे, 1 2 3 4 5 6 या 1 2 3 4 5 6. इफ आई टेक नंबरिंग 1 2 3 4 5 6 और इफ आई टेक नंबरिंग अपोजिट, 1 2 3 4 5 6 इज नॉट करेक्ट, दिस नंबरिंग इज करेक्ट. व्हाई? बिकॉज मिथाइल इज कमिंग ऑन सेकेंड पोजिशन. हियर द ग्रुप इज मिथाइल और फर्स्ट ब्रांच ऑन द सेकेंड पोजिशन. If I take numbering from this side here, 1 2 3, then the methyl coming on third position. So lowest number to first locant rule is to be obeyed here. Lowest number to first locant rule to be obeyed. Now if I take next point here, one more example here. Now we can have more carbon atoms. Now we can use here, suppose we have first locant here common. First locant is common, and then second locant can be taken this position. Then how the numbering to be done? Then the numbering done while using lowest sum rule. वो क्या बोलता है? If I take numbering from this side, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. If I take numbering from this side here, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. तो इन दिस केस व्हाट इज द सम टोटल ऑफ पोजीशंस नंबर. लोअर सम का मीनिंग क्या होता है, देख लीजिए. यहां पे क्या है, इस पोजीशन में चेंज का, चेन का पोजीशन में नंबर क्या है, 2 + 3, एंड देन योर नेक्स्ट ग्रुप इज 9 पोजीशन. 2 + 3 + 9, दैट इज हाउ मच, 9 + 3, 12 + 2, 14. इफ आई टेक नंबरिंग फ्रॉम दिस साइड हियर, 1 2, तो फर्स्ट ग्रुप इज एट 2 पोजीशन. Then next group is at position number 8, then position number 9. That is how much coming here? 10 plus 9, 19 ho gaya isme. So in this case, in first case the lowest sum rule is obeyed first numbering. So first numbering is correct. Lower in numbering is incorrect. Agar hamari chain do ka length, matlab dono mein first locant same position mein aa raha hoga. Agar hamara first locant dono mein kahan pe aa raha hai? Same position par. To kya dekhte hain yahan par? लोएस्ट सम रूल. जहां जहां ग्रुप लगे हैं उनका नंबरिंग कर लीजिए आप, 2 पे है, 3 पे है, 9 पे है, तो 2 प्लस 3 प्लस 9 कितना हो जाएगा 14। अगर आप यहां पे करें तो 2 प्लस 8 प्लस 9 कितना होगा 19 हो गया इसमें, ये बड़ा हो गया। तो यहां पे क्या लोवेस्ट सम रूल इज ओबेड इन फर्स्ट केस ओनली, तो वी ओबे लोवेस्ट सम रूल, बट रिमेंबर द प्रायोरिटी गिवन मोर टू द लोवेस्ट नंबर टू फर्स्ट लुक एट। इस पॉइंट को आप प्रायोरिटी देंगे पहले वाले पॉइंट को, इस दो वाले केस में इफ यू कॉन्ट्राडिक्शन फर्स्ट पॉइंट टू गिवन प्रायोरिटी। आई होप इट्स क्लियर दिस पॉइंट। देन हाउ टू राइट द, अच्छा वन मोर वी कैन टेक नंबरिंग वाइज, वन मोर पॉइंट इज टेकन इन नंबरिंग रूल, वन पॉइंट इज मोर टेकन व्हाट, दैट इफ वी हैव फर्स्ट लुकेंट ऑन सेम पोजिशन दे ओबे लोवेस्ट सम रूल, फर्स्ट लुकेंट रूल इज ऑल्सो ओबेड, टू लोवेस्ट नंबर टू फर्स्ट लुकेंट रूल इज ओबेड, देन हाउ टू राइट द नेम हियर, देन इफ वी हैव टू डिफरेंट ग्रुप्स, टू डिफरेंट ग्रुप्स एट सेम पोजिशन, सेम पोजिशन दे ओबे फर्स्ट लोवेस्ट नंबर टू, दे ओबे फर्स्ट लोवेस्ट नंबर टू फर्स्ट लुक एंड रूल, दे ऑल्सो ओबे लोवेस्ट सम रूल, देन वी सी दिस पॉइंट, इफ टू डिफरेंट ग्रुप्स आर एट सेम पोजिशन ऑन आइदर साइड देन बट ग्रुप आर डिफरेंट, देन द लोअर नंबर इज गिवन टू ग्रुप कमिंग फर्स्ट इन अल्फाबेटिकल ऑर्डर। लाइक इफ आई टेक द कार्बन चेन, इफ टेक नंबरिंग कैन बी डन फ्रॉम आइदर साइड 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 या 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8। फर्स्ट लुकेंट कहां पर है, थर्ड पे आ रहा है, यहां भी कहां पे आ रहा है, थर्ड पे आ रहा है, तो चेन आपका सेम रहेगा, नंबरिंग यू कैन डू मींस द प्रिंसिपल कार्बन चेन इज सेम। इफ आई टेक दिस प्रिंसिपल कार्बन चेन स्ट्रेट चेन, परफेक्ट, नो प्रॉब्लम। नाउ हाउ टू टेक नंबरिंग नाउ, तो इन दिस केस वी हैव ग्रुप इज टेकन मिथाइल, दिस ग्रुप इज इथाइल, सो व्हाट इन दिस केस व्हाट हैपन, द लोअर नंबर गिवन टू दैट ग्रुप व्हिच इज कमिंग फर्स्ट इन अल्फाबेटिकल ऑर्डर, इथाइल कम बिफोर मिथाइल इन अल्फाबेटिकल ऑर्डर, सो इथाइल ग्रुप विल गेट लोअर नंबर 2 3 4 5 6 7 8। दैट इज हाउ द कंपाउंड इज नेम्ड हियर एज, एंड फॉर दिस कंपाउंड हाउ द नेम कैन बी रिटन, इफ आई राइट द कंपाउंड नेम, नेम यू कैन राइट टू इंडिकेट द सब्स्टिट्यूएंट्स, वी इंडिकेट नेम ऑल्सो, लाइक फर्स्ट वी हैव 3 पोजीशन कंटेनिंग इथाइल, तो 3 इथाइल प्रीफिक्स 1, 6 पे आपका मिथाइल आ हुआ है तो 6 मिथाइल, 3 इथाइल 6 मिथाइल, देन द रूट वर्ड इज 8 कार्बन तो ऑक्ट, नो एल्कीन बॉन्ड एन, द कंपाउंड हैव नेम 3 इथाइल 6 मिथाइल ऑक्टेन। इन द नेम ओनली फर्स्ट नेम टू बी टेकन कैपिटल, only first name to be taken, first letter to be taken capital, rest all small names. I hope it is clear. Selection of the principal carbon chain, numbering of carbon atoms in the principal carbon chain, for numbering we have some rules, separate rules, there are some points that you have to be careful. Okay, let us take next point here now. Now compounds nomenclature of the branched chain alkanes, some points more we will take here. First today, numbers are separated from groups by hyphen. Already explained the example to you. And there is no break between the prefix, last prefix and the root word. Single name we write to a compound. And numbers are separated by commas. In case if two or more identical groups are present. When we have two or more same group present, then to indicate their number, like we have two groups are same, we use prefix di, tri, tetra, penta, hexa, before the name of the same group to indicate that many number in the prefix. Like we take the given two compounds name, how to write here, first we take selection of carbon chain, longest carbon chain same hai. Numbering identical either side 1 2 3 4 5, then for this compound what the name, we have two methyl groups, we don't write 2 methyl 4 methyl, no, we will write 2 comma 4 for 2 methyl groups di, S prefix, name of methyl complete, dimethyl, 5 carbon, pentane, no space between the prefix and the root word, no space, single name. How this compound can be named S? We can take numbering first here using lowest sum rule, because आपका यहाँ पे group वहाँ पे 2 पे आ रहा है, 1 2, यहाँ पे 2 पे आ रहा है, but 2 2 4, यहाँ पे 2 4 4, तो 2 2 4 is suitable, 1 2 3 4 5 is the numbering of the chain. How this compound can be named S? 2 comma 2 comma 4 trimethyl, 2 comma 2 comma 4 trimethyl pentane is the name for this compound. 2 2 4 trimethyl pentane. There is no spacing. Single name to be written continuation. That is how for the compound we can write the name. Now in case, let us take one more example here on this point. Now, next example can be taken this one. Again, I am not writing here hydrogens. It is understood that we, when we don't write hydrogen, they are balanced for the remaining positions. So, in this case, for this compound, what can be named? Like, is the name ka likhenge? First, we take selection of longest carbon chain. Carbon chain straight can be taken, longest carbon chain. Now, then we take numbering. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4. It can obey lowest sum rule, but it is first writing into what here? Lowest number to first look and rule. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. First we take numbering of the carbon chain, principal carbon chain, this one. And then write the name. We are having ethyl first, then methyl. So 3 ethyl, then hyphen 4 comma 4 to separate number commas. To separate number and words hyphens, 4 comma 4 dimethyl heptane. Remember the term taken D or T of di, tri, tetra, etc. are not taken for deciding alphabetical order. Alphabetical order of substituents, D or T of di, tri, tetra, are not taken for deciding the alphabetical order of the substituents. Are clear this point? Now, sometime we can have branched lookend or side chain. Then for branch side chain, how to break numbering? See, for branch side chain, numbering can be done by the rule as given here. We take branched chain, like if I take here, suppose I'll take the example. We take this longer carbon chain, it can have one group, this one group can be this one. Suppose this compound taken here. Now in this compound, what should be the name here? Dekhe. First we take longest carbon chain. Obviously it is straight chain, is longest carbon chain. Apply the lowest number to first look and rule. Kahan pe aa raha hai? 1, 2, 3, 4 pe aa raha hai. 1, 2, 3 pe aa raha hai. So 1, 2, 3 point to be given more priority. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It is numbering of the principal carbon chain. Now in side chain it is methyl, it is ethyl, it is tertiary butyl, but tertiary butyl is in common names. We will use what here? Grouping name here. So this can be named what here? This is taken as group. In this group, we take numbering again 1 dash, 2 dash. At 1 dash, we have 2 methyl and 1 simple. It is there. This is named what here? 1 dash, comma 1 dash, dimethyl. Then this is having 2 atoms, dimethyl ethyl. It is how we write the name of branch side chain. In branch side chain, the carbon atom attached to principal carbon chain, numbering 1, then 2, then and so on. To differentiate, when you use 1 dash, 2 dash, otherwise 1, 2 can also be work. So in this case, how the compound is named here? You can put 1 or 2 chalega isme. Aap press the side chain ka, but this name to be written in the brackets to indicate this position by after position. So how to write the name here of this compound? First we have methyl. देखिए इसमें नाम देगा फिर इथाइल फिर मिथाइल फिर डायमिथाइल इथाइल. डायमिथाइल इथाइल means methyl ethyl come later after methyl. So we write the name accordingly. This compound is named 7-ethyl. When we have two or more than two locants, different substituents, then we arrange them in alphabetical order. So पहले इथाइल फिर मिथाइल 3-methyl then 5 in the bracket the name for the side chain or this locant branch side chain 1 comma 1 hyphen dimethyl ethyl as a whole substituents root word is 8 10 carbon so name is decane. This is the compound's IBC name, decane. So when your side chain have branching, then we can numbering them as this one here. If I take one more example in this nomenclature. Now let us write the name for this compound. Now in this case, first we take selection of longest carbon chain. Account for lijiye 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We have same carbon chain length. The two chains are identical length. Now in that such case, how to take numbering or why, how we select longest carbon chain or principal carbon chain? In such a case, we select that carbon chain as principal carbon chain which contain more number of branches. In this chain, in this longest chain, we have how many branches? Only 2 branches. While we take this one, we have how many branches? 1, 2, 3 branches. So we take that carbon chain as the principal carbon chain which is having more number of branches or locants. So kaisa aayega usme? And then numbering. Numbering kaise karte hain? Lowest number to first locant rule. So 1, 2, 3, 1 late aayega. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And this become now as a whole substituents locant. So how to take numbering here? It is number 1. The carbon atom of the branch chain attached to main chain is taken number 1, then 2, then 3, then 4. That is how the numbering is done in this side chain. Then what is named here? It is named as ethyl butyl. 2 ethyl butyl. What is named here? Dimethyl means methyl and ethyl butyl. So ethyl butyl come first, then methyl. So how we write the name of the compound? 5 in the bracket we write the name here of locant 2 5 hyphen 2 ethyl butyl 2 ethyl butyl. Then the chain taken here 3 comma 3 dimethyl 3,3 dimethyl decane. No space. It is not named otherwise because this naming is correct because ethyl butyl come before methyl. This D is not taken, only methyl taken. It is ethyl butyl as a whole. And this carbon chain is taken principal carbon chain. Why? Because it contains more number of branches. That's the reason for this. Now, if I take a case where we can have two side chains branches identical type or different, then how to write the name of compound? Now let us take two more examples here of this branch side chain examples. Now if we have two or more identical branch side chains, then to indicate their number we put prefix bis, tris, tetrakis for 2, 3 and 4 such side chains. Bis and tris for 2 or 3 side chains which are same but branched. Like in this case we have two chains identical which are branch chains. How to write the names here? 1 2 1 2. It is name is what here? 1-methyl-ethyl, 1-methyl-ethyl. It is ethyl only. So how to write this compound name here? We write first ethyl then methyl-ethyl. So numbering done first here 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. Then the compound can be named as what here? First ethyl, 3 ethyl, then 4 comma 6, 4 comma 6 bis. In the bracket we write here the name of side chain methyl ethyl. It is methyl ethyl. Two group are identical, so we indicate them by prefix bis at 4 and 6 positions. Then the root word taken is 9 carbon, so nonane. Nonane. Now in second case, how to write the name of this compound? Now we are having chain identical but not same position wise. So numbering can be done 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Numbering can be same in either direction. But in this case one problem is there. We are how to write this group name here, which is to be taken first here? 1 2 3 1 2 3. It is named as 1-methyl-propyl 2-methyl-propyl. Name is same, methyl propyl, but number is 1-methyl-propyl to be given to be written first, then 2-methyl-propyl. So this numbering to be done from this side. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. It is named before this name because it is 1-methyl-propyl, it is 2-methyl-propyl. Name is same but numbering first. So it is named as 5 in the bracket 1-methyl propyl. Then 6 in the bracket 2 methyl propyl. Root word is same, decane for 10 carbons. Name of the compound then? Decane is the compound's correct name. So in this case, when the sometime compound name can be same, we cannot differentiate by alphabetical order, but number can distinguish. Use number in such cases. Okay, I hope it's clear. Now sometime this secondary neo iso can also be used in prefix names in branch side chains. Then how to write the name of compound in that case? One more example taken in such case. Now one point you can remember that in alphabetical order, this iso, neo, secondary, tertiary, they are common names. Basically they are using common names, but in some cases if we have single substituents in such cases, we allow these names. The alphabetical order of the prefixes iso and neo are considered to be part of the fundamental name of the alkyl group. This point to note down. The prefixes secondary and tertiary are not considered so. Means there are this term. Secondary, tertiary number aapka se link hai, they are not taken, but iso is used, neo can be used here along with the name of the name of the alkyl group. The use of iso and other related common prefixes is allowed by IUPAC as long as these are further not substituted. Isko dhyan rakhi point ko hai. Jaise example diya isme compound ka naam likhne ke liye, to for this compound what the name? Now we are having in this case two prefixes. One is isopropyl इट इज सेकेंडरी ब्यूटाइल. आइसोप्रोपाइल मीन्स आई विल बी टेकन, इट इज आइसोप्रोपाइल. तो आई विल बी कंसिडर हियर फॉर अल्फा वर्टिकल सीक्वेंस. इसका नाम क्या है? सेकेंडरी ब्यूटाइल. तो एस यहां पर नहीं लेंगे, ओनली वी टेक ब्यू, बी फॉर द सेकेंडरी ब्यूटाइल एस प्रीफिक्स नेम. आइसो को नहीं करते हैं, नियो पेंटाइल में नियो कंसिडर बिकॉज इट इज सिंगल नेम. यू डोंट पुट हाइफन आफ्टर आइसो. आइसो प्रोपाइल आप लिखेंगे इसमें, तो आइसो सेकंड ईयर दो आप यूज करेंगे. आइसो एंड नियो आर अलाउड बट सेकेंडरी एंड टर्शियरी नॉट अलाउड इन द फंडामेंटल नेम ऑफ द अल्काइल ग्रुप. तो फॉर दिस कंपाउंड हाउ वी राइट द नेम? आई बिफोर ब्यूटाइल कम बिफोर आइसो. तो दिस कंपाउंड इज नेम फर्स्ट डे कार्बन चेन लेंथ 1, 2, 3, 4. तो नंबरिंग टू बी डन फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट बिकॉज इट कैन बी लोवेस्ट नंबर टू लुक एट 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This compound is named what here then? Butyl को पहले लिखेंगे आप पे. It is named as 5-secondary butyl. Secondary butyl 4-isopentapropyl decane. These two the compounds I this name 5-secondary butyl. यहाँ पे B लिया हमने, यहाँ पे I लिया है. Sorry यहाँ पे अपने B लिया पे I लिया है, तो B पहले आएगा. So name this compound is not shown here. So I hope it is clear that the naming of the branched chain alkanes. Now we take cycloalkanes and then we take the naming of the poly functional group compounds after introduction of some common simple functional group compounds names. Okay.